I'm going to make a pillow. So I'd like to show you guys how to do it if you want to do it yourself. Though I'm sure everyone knows how to make a pillow and I'm the only one who's just learning how to use her sewing machine. So shout outs to my brother-in-law. I've just cut it already and then I folded it in half. And so I'm going to be turning it inside out to sew it so that you don't see all the stitching. And I'm going to mark out where I want to follow to sew. I don't know if that's something you do, but it's something I do because I can't really do straight lines. And once I finish drawing it out, I'm going to pin this ends down so that it sticks together and doesn't shift when I'm sewing. Know how to pin stuff, I've just realized. Ow, I just stabbed myself. I don't know how to pin something, you stab yourself in a finger. I think I'm doing too many pins. It's because you fold over this one piece. Maybe people shouldn't be learning how to make a pillow from me. I know how to make one pillow. You know, sewing is dangerous. There's needles all over the place. I drew this line straight so that I would sew straight, but then I realized you can only sew as straight as you can draw, and I can't draw straight either. I think I may have used way too many pins. So this is step two. I've pinned and marked down my fabric inside out, and now I'm ready to actually put it through the sewing machine. So I'm going to sew. This side is bent over, so you don't need to sew that side. And what I'm gonna sew are, I don't know, I flipped it around. The three open sides, but I'm gonna leave about a hand's width opening on one of the sides so that I can stuff it. All right, cross your fingers. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sew it forward a little bit and then we're gonna go backwards to create a knot. You wanna turn on your sewing machine first. And you want to make sure your boyfriend wasn't playing with the sewing machine so that you're not doing a strange stitch. Okay, so now that I've reached the corner, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift the foot of the sewing machine like that, and then I'm just going to spin the cloth. Let's move this over. Spin the cloth over, make sure that the pin is up, and then continue sewing. So let's just turn everything this way so that we don't have to start all over again. About there. And continue. All right, perfect. I'm gonna lift the foot up again. Now remember, this time when we go around, we're not gonna go all the way across the whole end. What we're gonna do is we're gonna stop and leave an opening so that you can stuff it. Perfect. And don't stab yourself with the needles. Okay. So now we're gonna go backwards to tie the knot. Then you're gonna lift the foot. I'm gonna pull the string and cut. All right, perfect. So let's take these needles out before I stab myself. I think I put one too many in here. Okay, so our next step is to turn the fabric inside out. So we find our opening and we just turn it inside out. So now here is the beginning of our pillow. Ta-da! Dun dun ta-da! So now we're gonna go ahead and stuff it. So you're gonna grab some stuffing and you're gonna stuff away. Stuff, 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 stuff away. Alright, take this hat off. air. So it's really quite easy. You just start shoving it in there. Now our pillow is completely flat. Now the only problem is there's an opening right here. Now you could either sew it closed or you can do something else. I'm not sure what to do. Or you can just do the non-sew steam stick closed thing. I'm a jig I'm about to do. And so all it is basically is some tape and then it's like an adhesive, a cloth adhesive. And so I'm going to sew and steam that, or not sew, sorry. I'm going to cut a strip about that size and put it under inside and then fold this over so that it's a little bit shut. And then you're gonna go over it with an iron. So I iron closed this end, and so now you have a great green pillow. That's it, my friends.